we keep falling in and out.
Subhanallah.
If there ever was a doubt.
Subhanallah.
Our hearts are so quick to break. At this moment our souls are awake.
Forgive yourself and defy your heart disease. Care for others and give your spirit a release.
We keep falling in and out.
Subhanallah.
If there ever was a doubt.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to the third episode of Moments for the Heart. Inshallah ta'ala, today we will be discussing some very beautiful issues such as what exactly do we mean when we say the heart, and I will tell you some amazing things about the heart. And really, inshallah, I believe this will increase your iman, really. So stay with us, inshallah, because we have some very interesting things to discuss in this very short episode, inshallah. First of all, we want to mention a few facts about the heart, and these really are amazing. I want to ask the viewers a question, and if you just think about this with me for 1 second. Why do you think when the heart beats, it contracts and then expands? Why do you think that this is the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala designed the heart, and He is the most beautiful of designers? Why do you think that is? Think about that for just 1 second. Why does my heart beat like that? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is al-hakim, you know, the most wise. If He wanted, He could have made another way for blood to circulate through the body. It doesn't have to be through contracting and expanding of the heart. He could have made another way. It's easy for Him, right? So why? Why did He choose this method? I will tell you why. Because this, brothers and sisters, is what your tongue does when it says Allah. Your heart is saying Allah. Think about it. Allah. Allah. Your heart is expanding and contracting just like your tongue. Your heart is saying Allah. Your heart is making dhikr. It's remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Think about the nature of the universe, really. If you think about everything, you see that everything is making dhikr. We live in a world of creation. This is something that's fantastic. We live in a created world where all of the creation of Allah worships Allah. This is something that the Quran says. The Quran says that everything worships Allah, but you can't always perceive the way that it happens. So everything is making dhikr. Dhikr, again, for those who don't speak Arabic, it means, the best translation is litanies. Litanies. It's something where you're saying very small prayers, but the goal is to remember your Creator. You could be asking Allah for forgiveness, or you could be asking Allah, you could not be asking Him for anything, just praising Him. For example, one of our dhikr that we say, Subhanallah, glory be to Allah, to this beautiful Creator who created everything, to the most wise, to the most loving, to the controller and fashioner of everything. Right? So, the point is that this beautiful Creator made creation making dhikr to Him all the time, remembering Him all the time. And that includes your heart. Your heart is making dhikr. The ocean is making dhikr. Really. When the tide comes in, it's expanding. When it goes back out, it's extracting. Right? Same thing your heart is doing. Same thing your tongue does when it says Allah. Same thing. You know, we live in a world that worships Allah. The only beings that don't really worship Allah is us. It's amazing. Even our heart, the center, the core of our being, our very life force, is worshiping Allah 24 hours a day, but you aren't. The rest of you, the rest of your body, has forgotten. This is one of the amazing facts about the heart. But I'll tell you something. The position of our ulama who have studied the heart, the position of our scholars who have studied the heart, the nature of the heart and the soul and these sort of things, and the methods for purification, they've mentioned something very fascinating. That even though the heart is making dhikr, it can still be corrupted. Right? It can still be polluted. For example, the position of Imam Ghazali, rahimahullah, he said that we should think of the heart like a well. Right? A well that you would drink water from. You want the water in that well to be pure. You want it to be clean. You want it to be cool. Right? You don't want it to be full of mud. You don't want it to be hot and not refreshing. Right? So Imam Ghazali, he said, so we have to make sure that our well is not polluted. How do we do that? He said there are 5 streams that feed the well, and those are the 5 senses. your seeing, your vision, your hearing, your taste, your smell, your touch. He said, if just one of these streams is polluted, the well is polluted. What's he saying? What's he saying is, monitor your intake. That's what he's saying. Make sure that what you see, what you're looking at, you're not seeking haram. That you're not wanting to touch haram, smell haram, taste haram, right? That things that are forbidden by Allah, right? And this is the only way, really. This is the main way that we can purify that well. And I will tell you something, that we can even give life to a polluted heart. Even if your well is polluted, it doesn't mean that it's polluted forever and so you should just lose hope, right? Well, my well is polluted. Nothing I can do. It's poisoned. Let's board it up and never drink from it again. No, this is not the concept in Islam. You can correct yourself right now. Just do it, right? Just say, okay, I'm getting up to pray Fajr this morning. That's it. I'm tired of being depressed. I'm tired of being unhappy. I'm tired of feeling like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has abandoned me to my own affairs. Sheikh Al-Qarni, he's the guy who wrote the very famous book, Don't Be Sad. He said, if you find that your life is mired in misery and depression and misfortune and poverty, he said, why don't you take that as a sign that Allah, God Almighty, has abandoned you to your own affairs? Maybe you'll succeed and maybe you won't, but you don't have His support. Because we believe in Islam that you can be taken outside of the providential care of Allah through your actions. But you can always come back into His care by obeying Him. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam related in a hadith Qudsi that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I love nothing more from my servant except that he does what I ordered him to do. Not all of these extra acts of worship, he doesn't love those as much as he loves you getting up every morning to pray Fajr. This he loves more than anything. He doesn't love your dhikr as much as he loves your praying Zuhr and your praying Asr and having kushu'ah and focus. He loves those more than anything. But the hadith goes on to say, this hadith Qudsi goes on to say, but my servant continues doing supererogatory, or that is extra acts of worship, until I love him. Making that extra dhikr, praying those sunnah prayers, qiyamul layl, fasting on Monday and Thursday, reading Qur'an. My servant keeps doing these things until I love him. And when I love him, and this is so beautiful, please listen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when I love my servant, I become his eyes with which he sees, his ears with which he hears, his hands with which he strikes, and if he asks from me, I would surely give it to him. Subhanallah. We worship the most beautiful of creators. So the point is that even if your well is polluted, you can change that right now. You can turn that all around right now. Just do it. Just stop making excuses and just do it. Really, that's it. Turn off the television. And just do it. Read Quran, make some dhikr, And don't just, this dhikr that I'm seeing people make, astaghfirullah, 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 and then they get up. What is that? That's going to purify your heart, you think? This is an empty ritual. An empty ritual isn't going to help anyone, right? So when you're making dhikr, dedicate some time. I'm going to sit down and I'm going to make dhikr for 20 minutes, until I feel pure. Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, he said, never do I face a problem in my life, something that I'm worried about, something that I'm upset over, except that I sit down and I say, Astaghfirullah, forgive me Allah, 900 to 1,000 times, or maybe more, or maybe less. And he said, by the time I'm done with that, whatever I was worried about, I feel that it's so silly. I have no worry. I know that Allah will take care of it. Or he said, by the time I'm done, I found the answer. Whatever the problem was, I found the answer. This is somebody that has yaqeen. This is a great person, And really, we should be great people. We should be that caliber of person that says, I'm just going to do it. I'm just going to get up right now. I'm going to make wudu. I'm going to sit down and I'm going to make dhikr until I feel that I have no problems. Really, something amazing. Imam Bukhari, he had a tasbih, like the masbah, they call it here, that had 1,001 beads on it. And he would hang it on his bedpost. And before he went to bed every night, he would say, Subhanallah, 1,001 times. Alhamdulillah, 1,001 times. Allahu Akbar, 1,001 times. What have you done? This is Imam Bukhari. Not even a Sahaba. Not Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, just a man that wanted to purify his heart and give something back to the ummah. What have you done? Ask yourself that. What have you done to become a great person? What have you done to purify your well? And I want to tell you a story about how the well, the heart, can be purified. And this is a true story, and wallahi, it happened to me last night. This is not something that happened a long time ago. It happened last night, and I will close with this story, inshallah. I was on the Nile, the Nil, as they say here, on the Nile, on a boat. A friend invited us, you know, and he's very nice, mashallah. And we're eating dinner, you know, alhamdulillah, on the Nile. And it's like a tourist thing, but we're on the top of the boat because below the boat, on the bottom levels, they're doing some dancing and this sort of thing. And of course, you know, we're Muslims. We don't want to see this sort of thing. It's for tourists, you know. So we're on top of the boat, and I see the brother who's helps operate the boat, and he's involved in tourism and this sort of thing. You know, clean shaven, and he's wearing rings that have like some shirk on it. You know, because, you know, he likes to please the tourists. So it has like, you know, some statues and this sort of thing. And he's wearing this as a ring. And he's smoking, you know, cigarettes and things. And so I have my friend, he's Arab, and I don't speak Arabic very clearly. I mean, I know some things, but nothing very clear. So I have my friend go and I say, will you ask them if I can tell them some things and just translate for me? So they say, yeah, and we sit down. And I tell them everything I'm telling you right now about the heart. You know, this is somebody that maybe he's not even making salah. Allahu alam. You know, and you can just tell by his face, he has no tranquility, no peace before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so, I start telling him about the heart, and I start telling him about dhikr, and I start telling him what it's done for me in my life, which inshallah I hope to mention in some future episodes. Wallahi, by the end of the conversation, I saw that his face had become so peaceful. And he insisted when I got up to give me a hug. He just wanted to embrace me. And he held me so tight, Yani. And he offered to take me for free as a tour to all the masjids in Egypt. Wallahi al-azim, I swear by Allah. You know, because he felt so pure in that moment. And he was so thankful. And he had never thought about the heart that way. You know, do you think about your heart? Do you think about your soul and your place before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You know, I told you I would close with that story, so I leave you with that thought. Are you ready to revive the well? Are you ready to just get up and do it? I ask you to think about that. Thank you for joining us, and we hope to see you again on our next show, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
We keep falling in and out,
subhanallah.
If there ever was a doubt,
subhanallah.
Our hearts are so quick to break. At this moment our souls are awake.
Forgive yourself and defy your heart disease. Care for others and give you spirit and release.
We keep falling in and out,
subhanallah.
If there ever was a doubt,
subhanallah.
The ultimate fact, if merely in you,
subhanallah,
that Allah's mercy ever look after you,
subhanallah.